In this video, we're going to look at the difference between molecular and empirical formula, and then we'll use an example to find the empirical and molecular formula. Before we start to determine what is empirical and molecular formula, I think it's good if we figure out what's the difference between these two terms. Molecular formula basically tells us the number of atoms that's present in the formula. An example is C6H12. We know that there are 6 carbons and 12 hydrogens present. Empirical formula, on the other hand, gives us the formula in the simplest ratio. Take that C6H12 molecular formula, for example. If we reduce it down to the simplest ratio, we should get CH2. That's the empirical formula. However, sometimes we can't reduce the molecular formula further. In that case, both the empirical and the molecular formula will be the same. That's just something that we need to keep in mind. Let's try finding the empirical and molecular formula using an example. Here we have a question that gives us the percent composition of Fe and O. We're asked to find the empirical and the molecular formula. There are 3 steps to find the empirical formula. We need to first find the mole for each atom, and then using the moles for each atom, we're going to find the mole ratio. Using the mole ratio, we're then going to find the whole number ratio that will give us the empirical formula. From the empirical formula, we'll figure out the factor, multiply it in, and then that will give us the molecular formula. Let's start with the first step, finding the mole. We are given 72.35 Fe and 27.65% O. We are going to assume that we have 100 grams of sample. Therefore, the mass of Fe is 72.35 grams and the mass of oxygen is 27.65 grams. We convert the percentage to grams so that it will allow us to calculate the mole of each element. So all we have to do now is to divide the given mass with the atomic mass of the element, and then that will give us the mole. So we get 1.296 mole of Fe, and we do the same for oxygen. Except for now, we divide with the atomic mass of oxygen, which is 15.999, and that gives us 1.728 mole of oxygen. Now that we're done with the first step, we're going to proceed to the second step, which is finding the mole ratio. So using the mole that we have already calculated for Fe and O, we're going to divide with the smallest mole. Between 1.296 and 1.728, 1.296 is smaller. Since 1.296 is the smallest value, we divide both of the mole with 1.296, and then we get 1 for Fe and 1.33 for O. Now we're almost done. We need to now move on to the final step, which is getting the whole number ratio. Now it might be tempted at this point to just round down that 1.33 and just say the ratio is going to be FeO, 1 to 1. However, just note that that is not the right thing to do. You need to actually convert it to a whole number ratio. To get the whole number ratio, we're going to look at the ratio that we found for Fe, which is 1, O is 1.33. 1 is already a whole number, so we're not going to worry about that. But then looking at O, it's 1.33, that is not a whole number. So we need to multiply 1.33 with 3, and that's going to give us 4. That's a whole number. Now, if we multiply 1.33 with 2, we're going to end up getting 2.66, and that's not a whole number. That's why we go with 3. So if you're not sure like what number to multiply, just start from 2, work your way up, and then you'll see which number will give you a whole number. And once you found that, like in our case, it's times 3, we need to do the same thing for Fe. So that will give us 3 Fe. So now we do have the whole number ratio for Fe and O. So that gives us the empirical formula Fe3O4. From the empirical formula, we can easily find the molecular formula. We start by calculating the formula mass for the empirical formula. We find the atomic mass for Fe and O, multiply them with 3 and 4, add it up, and that gives us 231.531 grams per mole. That's the mass for Fe3O4. That's the empirical mass formula. Now, the molecular formula is the empirical formula times a factor n. We don't know what is n, and we can find that out by dividing the given molar mass with the mass of Fe3O4, which is our empirical formula. Plugging in the given molar mass, 231.5 grams per mole, divide by the formula mass of our empirical formula, that comes out to be roughly 1. So that means the molecular formula for this compound is actually the same as the empirical formula, which is Fe3O4. With that, we're done looking at empirical and molecular formula. We found the empirical formula by first finding the mole for each element, and then we divide with the smallest mole to find the mole ratio. After that, be sure to convert the mole ratios into whole numbers. Otherwise, you're going to get the wrong empirical formula. And then once you get the empirical formula, we find N to figure out what's the molecular formula. I have other videos in this series on percent composition, limiting reactant, percent yield, and percent purity. I'll place their links in the description box below. Be sure to check them out. Here's a video that I've handpicked for you. Do check out our app that's available in both Google Play and App Store. Thanks for watching all the way till the end. If you find this video helpful, be sure to like and share it with someone. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon so you won't miss future videos. Your support means a lot to me.